My father-in-law, his mother is 101 and she's still going strong. I'm going to tell you about her diet. My wife is from Taiwan, and I was over there recently, and we were all sitting around, having drinks and everything. You know, it was kind of the Saturday night, and we're doing kanpais, you know, and drinking down the beer and the wine and everything else we got. And suddenly it comes up that my father-in-law, his mother is 101 years old, and she's still out there. She still works every day. She's out in the yard. She's, you know, grabs his bundles of sticks and brings them in, makes fire. She does all this stuff. So I said, 101, my ears perked up. And so I said, okay, everybody stop right now. What is it that she eats? She has a very simple diet. And it's not only about what she eats, but also what she does not eat. This is the interesting part. So, I said, okay, what does she eat? She's almost a vegetarian. So she doesn't eat any meat. She's never eaten meat at any point in her life, okay? She eats fish twice a week. That's it. Twice a week, very small amount of fish, very small, maybe like, you know, just maybe like a half a fish at the most. And then she eats sweet potatoes, and that's very common over there in Taiwan. You know, it's very popular, and sweet potatoes, much more healthier than regular potatoes, without any doubt. And then last but not least, she never eats, well, I'll leave that out for the end, but she doesn't eat any fried foods. But it's not only what she doesn't eat, what she does eat, she eats like this big porridge bowl, call it a soup. It's like a seaweed soup. It's got all sorts of Chinese herbs in there. It's a very traditional Chinese dish, Taiwanese dish. She's actually Taiwanese, really, more than Chinese, but you know, it's very similar. And that's her diet, and that's what she eats, and she's been living that way almost all of her life. So what is left out? Well, she doesn't eat any processed food. She never has eaten anything out of a package, ever. She, you know, everything's fresh, right? She gets the seaweed at the local market. She brings it in, and she makes all these kind of whatever you want to call it, a porridge or a stew or a soup or whatever. And never in her life has she eaten fried foods. That's the key. This is the worst thing you can put into your body. Is a fried food. I mean, it's really, really destructive to the food. You're creating huge amounts of free radicals when you fry foods. And, you know, you're breaking down the oil. It's really terrible. And then you consume this. It's really the worst thing you can possibly consume is any kind of fried foods. And I see fried foods all over the world. It's not like, you know, we're the only ones in this country, the U.S., that fry foods. We have fried chicken, this kind of stuff. But honestly, I see it everywhere. I see the, you know, the deep pots, and they're going full blast, and they like to fry things. You go to the night markets in Taiwan, and they're just, they got all this junk, all this crap, all this fried food, all this junk food. So we're not the only ones in the world that eat that, but we eat the most of it.
This is fried butter.
Fried butter.
I think there's no doubt. So that's what she lives on, 101 years old. You know, she's not even a raw foodist or anything, but it shows you how incredibly healthy you can be at any age when you just eat the right diet. And I mean, she could be going a lot farther and a lot longer if she would add a lot more raw foods into her diet. She does eat a fair amount of fruit. She likes that. She has a lot in the morning, but pretty much for the most part, it's what I told you, the sweet potatoes, and these, you know, and the porridges that she makes for herself. That's it. And again, not only that, what she leaves out the junk, the processed foods, the fried foods, and she eats no animal protein whatsoever except fish only twice a week. That's how you stay healthy at any age. And 101, she's going full blast. Dr. Bob, I'll see you next time. If you like my work and my philosophy, you might like some of my books, The Miraculous Properties of Ionized Water, The Seven Components to Great Health, Silver, The Miracle Mineral, The End of Infectious Disease, and God's Path to Disease-Free Living, What the Scriptures Tell Us About Health.